Hello friends, myself Tushar Ugale, Assistant Professor, Department of Agriculture and Entomology, K.K.Wagh College of Agriculture, Nashik. Today we will go through this mass production of Entomopathogenic Nematode, that is EPN. Background of EPN, the Entomopathogenic Nematode possessing balanced biological control attributes belong to genera Nema and Heterorhabdis. These are two major genera having the wide range of the EPN and are having mutualistic association with the bacteria of the genus Generaptus and Stenomatidae and Photoraptus for the Heterorhabditae. Entomopathogenic nematode being highly lethal, causing death of the many important insect pests which are agriculturally important. This death of the insect can occur within 24 to 28 hours as they compare with days and week requires of the insect killing out the biological control like fungus and bacteria. Only 12 species out of the rarely nearly 80 identified strain nematodes and heterorhabditis nematode species have been commercialized for the use of plant protection. The EPNs having a great potential to be used in integrated pest management system with a residue free and totally chemical free option. Entomopathogenic nematode, commonly known as the EPN, Entomopathogenic nematode, as name indicate, it causes disease to insect, and hence it is very beneficial that parasitizing the crop insect, particularly Lepidoptera and Coleoptera insect, which is very having wide range as a crop pest among the all agriculture crops. Introduction of nematodes, entomopathogenic nematodes. These are the soft-bodied, non-segmented roundworm that are obligate, means living, only preferred in the living host. Sometimes facultative parasites of the insect, entomopathogenic nematodes occurs naturally in soil environment and locate their host in response to carbon dioxide, vibration and other chemical cues. Species of two families, Heterorhabditae and Stenomatidae, have been effectively used against insect as a biological insecticides in the previous eras also. It is reported by the Gribal et al. In 2000. Entomopathogenic nematodes fits nicely into the integrated pest management practices, which are considered non-toxic to human being for the mammals, and it is only work against the specific to their target pest. It is can be applied with standard pesticide equipments. Like the conventional pesticide application equipment can be used. Entomopathogenic nematodes have been exempted from the US Environmental Protection Agency EPA for the pesticide registration. Even in India, CIB is a leading organization involved in the certification or registration of pesticide. It is also exempted registration. It is the difference between EPN and PPN. EPN stands for entomopathogenic nematode, PPN stands for plant parasitic nematode. In EPN, it is only parasitic to insect pest, pass one of the stage their life cycle in the insect pest, where in the plant parasitic nematode is parasite parasitized mainly root system of the plants, and it completes the life cycle being endoparasitic or ectoparasitic nematode. EPN is beneficial to agriculture crops that as compared with plant parasitic nematode, it is harmful for the agriculture crop, causes root knots, root lesion, root system, damaging the root system, also give the entry to plant pathogens. EPN increase the crop yield by killing the crop pest. It as versus plant parasitic nematode, it reduce the yield more than 50%, 15% to 100% sometimes. When we compare the size, it is very small, that is 0.3 to 1.5 mm. And the plant parasitic nematode is near about 4 mm in size. EPN life cycle generally completes within a week, but in case of plant parasitic nematode, it takes near about 2 to 3 weeks. Sometimes it also takes 4 weeks to complete its life cycle. EPN feed on the bacteria and decomposing host insect and having very great association with the bacteria. Plant parasitic nematode feed on the plant parts, main roots get the taxonomy of nematode. The phylum nematoda, class Serenemeta, order Rhabdidia, suborder Rhabdiciana, superfamily Rhabdidia, family study nematode heterorhabditidae, this having the nematodes which cause the entomopathogenic effect. Why EPN is considered as a good biopesticide? Because of some its attributes like ability to search its host insect, target insect by the chemoreceptor. Quick killing action is observed of the target pest. It possesses a broad host range. It never very easy to locate its host. Easily culture, it is a main attribute that it is very easy to mass production of this EPN in laboratory. It is highly compatible with many pesticides which can be applied through the conventional plant protection activities. It is easy delivery system by spraying of EPN suspension, or it can be given through the irrigation system. It is very safe to all vertebrates, animals, plants, non-targeting insects. It is also environmentally safe, causing no pollution at all. It gives long-term control, substantial control. Means if we applied once in ecosystem, then the insect cadaver or the dead insect also act as a disseminating agent, or it is also cause a secondary infection to another insect which are the established in ecosystem. It also exempted from the registration of. This is the photograph showing the these are some entry points for the nematode in insect larvae. Major these are acting on the larvae which are very having slow activity. The mouth is a major entry of the EPN. This is the second one is the anus, which is used for excreting the fecal matter. The pseudo legs or pseudo podia means the leg like structure, or only the probe are on the body of the insect, also having surface contact with soil when they are moving from here and there. This pseudopodia also having the entry points for the EPN. Again, the spherical lateral insect body on laterally having the spiracles which are mainly purpose for this respiration, also get the entry for the EPN. This is the picture showing the partially desiccated EPN, and the insect body is getting damaged with the full of juveniles of entomopathogenic nematode. The infective juveniles getting out from the body of insect. There is one interesting thing that nematode and bacterium having very great mutualism, and it is having very good complex, and it works two way. Nematode depends on the bacterium for killing the host, creating suitable environment for nematode development, and prevent the secondary infection by the microbes. It also serving as a food source, break down host tissue to serve the nutrient sources. It is very helpful for the nematode development. It also breaking down the host tissue, which tissues cannot be damaged by the nematode. The bacterium help to damage that type of tissue, and it providing the required nutrient nematode. Again, the bacterium also depends on the nematode as a symbiotic relationship. Protection from the external environment provided by the nematode to the bacteria. Penetration into the host hemophile, that is an insect body cavity, is only through the nematode. Inhibition of host antibacterial proteins, which are very harmful to the development of the bacteria, is inhibited along with penetration through the nematode body. Nematode bacteria complex having some examples. These are some examples from the study: Nema, Aphanis, Prosia, Felkia, Carpocapsi. These are some species which are present today, and also reviewed by many scientists, many researchers in this field. These are some also species from heterodiabetes. These are the associated bacterial species which are associated as a mutual association between nematodes and bacteria which cause insect. Diagnostic character between Serenema and heterodiabetes nematodes. These are in Srinama, the symbiotic bacterial species is present general dust, and in this bacterial location within a specialized intestinal vesicle of the nematode. But in the case of heterorhabdis, the species bacterial species associated is photorhabdus. Bacterial location last 2 to 3 intestinal vesicles. The adults of the study nema having the excretory pore located at the anterior to nerve ring spicules ventrally arcuate. Bursa is absent. Genital papillae is at the 10th or 11th pair, where the excretory pore located in the case of heterorhabdis to the posterior to nerve ring spicules near straight and bursa is present. Genital papillae at the 9th pair of its appendages. Infectiogenous having excretory pore at anterior to nerve ring in the case of Srinema, whether in heterorhabdis excretory pore posterior to the nerve ring. Luminescence never shown by the Srinema, but in the case of heterorhabdis the luminescence means the shining effect is shown in the case of heterorhabdis. Color of the dead larvae is a blade in the case of Srinema, but in the case of heterorhabdis it is a pleuridine red or pinkish type of. This is the infection of study nematode, nematodes and symbiotic bacteria general raptor species. The complex gives a big bicolor to the waxworm, cadaver waxworm. That is Galeria species infected with the study nematode, nematode. And this is the infection of heterorhabdis nematode with the photorhabdus species, bacterial species, giving the red or pink color to the waxworm. These are the some wide range of the host from Coleoptera to Lepidoptera, which is infected by the nematode. These are these insect, these are the infective juveniles of the study nema and male and female structure. It is very microscopic to observe, not observed by the naked eyes. Again, maybe move towards the life cycle of EPN. After entering in an insect, infective juveniles release associated mutualistic bacteria. These bacteria of the genus Genoraptus and Photoraptus for study nematodes and heterorhabdis respectively cause a host mortality within 24 to 48 hours. Means it is having very fastest result than the bacterium. Bacteria cause septicemia, which is associated with nematode, by production of toxins and exoenzymes, which eventually kill the insect easily. The nematode providing shelter to bacteria, as we seen earlier, which is where turns kill the insect host and provide nutrient to the nematode, which is very effective. Effectively control the insect. Together, the nematode and bacteria feeds on the liquefying host or the insect, which in the case of this insect body oozing out and on the fluid. These both organism, nematode and bacteria, feeds inside the body of host. The life cycle of Entomopathogenic nematodes. When nematode are released into the environment or in the soil, it again search its natural host through its opening or cuticle. Directly it parasitize its host. These are some difference as seen earlier with heterorhabdis and Srinema. These nematodes eventually kill the insect and feed inside the body of the insect, and the bacteria also works help to killing the insect. After killing of insect, again the cadaver, that is the dead body of the insect, release or most of the juveniles actually the infective parts or infective young ones of the nematode are again emerge from the infectious cadaver, and again it life cycle is going on for the searching of the new host. This is the photograph showing that these are the some nematodes emerging out from the dead insect. It is the photo taken in laboratory. This is a cricket and this is a Lepidoptera larvae having very fastest moving the nematodes EPN, which is very active during the when they are feeding on the insect body is very active, and again it is a very good example to have a great biological control. This pupa of Lepidoptera paste showing that these are the infective juveniles oozing out from the dead body of that pupa. this pupa may be infected in larval stage before the pupation, or after the pupation also it is possible to infect the. Mass production techniques for EPN is very easy. It can be mass produced in on the suitable host, that is in vivo, or maybe on semi-synthetic diet in vitro. Both techniques of mass production of EPN have their own advantages and limitations. In vivo production means with the help of the suitable host, maybe used in laboratory. There are identified three hosts are identified. First is Galleria melanella, Carceris epon, that is a rice moth, Helicoparme, that is the our American bollor or gram pod. The method of preparation, diet and mass multiplication of the host insect. For the Galleria, there is one artificial diet is identified by the research worker. It includes gram flour, wheat bran, skim milk powder and yeast tablets and glycerin and honey. These are the ingredients of the artificial diet for the to rearing the Galleria larvae. This is the procedure: grind yeast tablet into fine powder, mix with the corn flour, wheat bran and milk powder. Glycerin and honey can be mixed separately. Finally, part A and B mixed thoroughly, homogeneous mixture is prepared. The content of artificial diet is distributed into two plastic containers or plastic wide mouth jar having 5 liter capacity. About 1000 of first and second instar Galleria larvae are released in a container incubated in 35 degrees Celsius temperature. The larvae will be ready for use with the 3 bags. If the temperature is less than 35 degrees Celsius, the temperature larvae will be low. Extraction of PPN from the field to get natural isolate is a very easy method. We have to collect the soil samples, random soil samples from the field. And the baiting of the fresh non-parasitized Galleria melanella larvae into that soil. After a few days, the larvae will be infected with nematode, and we have to collect the infected larvae. Then we have to extract or isolate this EPN from the infected larvae's body. Again, we have to reinfection and re-isolation of EPN for the commercial production. Then after the re-isolation of PPN, we can store in distilled water at 8 degrees Celsius for the further use. This is the rearing photograph showing the rearing of Galleria melanella in an artificial diet. This is oviposition container where we can keep the adults, and these adults giving the bunch of eggs, mass, female lays egg on the black sheet or on a paper strip. The neonate just hatched out from this eggs is showing here. It is the fully grown matured larvae. It is very suitable larvae having the good biomass for the infection of the nematode. This is the plastic jar where we are giving the artificial diet, and on this diet this type of larvae is getting feeding. This is the pupa. This is pupa. This is the puparium. This is the cover of pupa, where inside the pupa in silken webs pupation is occurred, and after that pupation it again develop into the adult stage, and again the life cycle is going on. This is the Heteroptis infected larvae of Galleria showing the luminescence. It is a very particular characteristic of the Heteroptis. It is not observed in case of sterile nematode. Again, the Carceris epholnica is another source, another host for this rearing of this EPN. It is commonly known as the rice moth. This is the ingredient required for this rearing. This is life cycle of Carceris epholnica. It starts from egg mass to adult. Again, likewise the Galleria. This is the Carceris rearing box. Wooden boxes are used to rear this insect, Carceris epholnica rice moth. It is very popular insect, host insect for the trichomonas. This is the Helicoparme as a paste. It is very popular, but in case of laboratory, with help of this insect field collection, we can use for the rearing of this nematode. it is not economical to have artificial diet for the rearing of helicorum major. But in rabi season, the crop like gram or chickpea, we can very easily we can bring the larvae into laboratory for the further application. These are the some diet ingredient and procedure for the rearing of this helicorum larvae in laboratory. This is the life cycle of helicorum paramagera. And again, having complete type of metamorphosis, the larvae very voraciously feeds on artificial diet. This type of multi vial tray can be used for to feeding the larvae, because this helicorum larvae having the cannibalism, means one species of the same insect is feeding on the another species. This type of ice tray, even this type of multi-vial tray can be used for the rearing. This is the piece of artificial diet prepared from the this ground floor mainly, and agar is used for this as a solidifying agent. Production of EPN in vivo. Production of EPN in insect is generally done by using the white trap method. Insect is inoculated with EPN on a petri dish lined with a filter paper. While after 2 to 5 days, infected insects are transferred to white trap. This method consists of a dish on which cadavers, that is a dead insect, rest on the inverted watch glass surrounded by water. The central dish containing the cadavers provide a moist environment surroundings for the EPN emergence from the cadaver. This help to emerge out cadaver the juveniles from the cadaver. New progeny of infective juveniles that emerge from the cadaver migrate to the surrounding water, where they are trapped subsequently harvested. This method has advantage that infective juveniles migrate away from the host cadaver and on emergence and continue to do so until the body contents of the host are consumed. This is a white trap method for harvesting of EPN emerged from the Galleria larvae. This is the filter paper placed over which the cadaver placed in the wash glass with the surrounding of. This is the another photograph showing the this is circular arrangement on this glass petri dish, and this insect cadaver are infected with the entomopathogenic. Production of EPN in vitro. In vitro production is there are some various medias which used for the production of EPN. In the roots medium, modified roots medium, wheat medium, modified wheat flour medium, egg yolk media. This is egg yolk media. Second, again the modified egg yolk medium, dog biscuit medium, modified dog biscuit medium. These are several medias studied by the different scientists and co-workers earlier. This type of media can be used production of the nematodes, but it is a very tough method to having the commercial production with quality juveniles. It is procedure of the mixing the ingredient, mix the ingredient and coat on the polyurethane from cut into the small cubic pieces till the latter soak in the medium. 1.5 gram of foam chips or near about 1 gram foam chips, 8 to 9 gram medium weight by weight basis should be selected. The flask filled with the foam media impregnated with the water and autoclaved for 20 minutes at 121 degrees Celsius and allowed to cool. Fresh infected juveniles extracted from the insect, as discussed earlier, will be used each time to avoid the prior inoculation of bacterium into the flask. The nematode should be inoculated aseptically into the flask. That is, you have to take a great care. The other contamination should not be entered into the flask. It should be inoculated near about 1000 infective juveniles per flask. Incubate this sealed flask at 28 degrees Celsius for 25 days. The colonies of EPN will start appearing on the wall of the flask after 2 to 3 weeks after the. After 25 days of inoculation, infective juveniles will be harvested. peel up the foam chips on 100 mesh sieve. Place the sieve in a pan with distilled water overnight. The nematode sediments pass through the 250 mesh sieve in a pan of water. About 95% infective juveniles migrate into the water within 2 hours and sterilize with the 0.1 hymen solution. Wash thighs with sterile distilled water and collect store at room temperature. After concentrating nematode suspension with the help of microfiltration assembly, EPN will be kept in the kept for the further use. Storage may be done at 8 degrees Celsius for the use. Compatibility of EPN with the nematode with pesticide is having very great compatibility with most of all agrochemicals, including herbicides, fungicides, acaricides, insecticides. Even it is very easy to use in soil, in some borer holes on the stem borer. Nemol is non-toxic to EPN, however it is a commercial formulation. Addition of detergents make it toxic to EPN, so it is not advised to use the detergent or any kind of synthetic soaps or stickers, spreaders before the technical compatibility knowledge. Some pesticides act as synergistically with EPN, increase the effective potential of EPN and therefore improve efficacy in additive results. Imidacloprid and Teflutrid act as a synergistically with EPN, it giving very good results when they are used in together. Sterinema Glacerin was compatible with carbapenem, furet, pinol, fos and aldrin. Sterinema carpocapsi was compatible with dimethyl, endosulfan, malathion, mancozib and genib like the fungicide. The other with the recommended doses. Two species of Sterinema, that is Sterinema glaceri and Sterinema filti, Heterodaptis indica, are highly compatible with urea and even muriate of potash up to the concentration of 400 ppm. These sterinematids are more compatible with 100 ppm of superphosphate, while Heterodaptis are compatible up to 200. The merits of entomopathogenic nematode are extraordinarily lethal to many important insects pest, yet they are safe to non-resident organisms like animals or our other insect and even for human being. This is a high degree of safety means unlike chemicals, even basal thuringiensis nematode application do not require any safety measures like mask or any safety equipment on re-entry time residue, groundwater contamination, disease, chemical trespasses, all this issue for pollinators, these are not issue in case of nematode. Nematodes are amenable to mass production, do not require specialized application equipment as they are very compatible with standard agrochemical equipment. Even we can use the traditional way like the other pesticides. Application of nematode, entomopathogenic nematodes are also reported to be compatible with a number of agrochemicals as we seen earlier. The EPN have a great potential to be used in integrated pest management system as like the biological control method, mechanical method or chemical method. Entomopathogenic nematode can be applied with nearly all agronomic and horticulture ground equipments including the pesticide sprays, mist blow, electric sprays and aerial. This is all about the entomopathogenic nematode and its role in control of insect and mass production techniques. Thank you.